What's up guys and welcome back to the channel. You know it's a boy and me King, and today I'm gonna be giving you part 15 of What If Naruto Was Taken by the Raikage. Get this one to 300 likes and you'll be getting the next part as soon as possible. Comment down below and tell me what you think of this episode and share this to all of your friends on your social media platform. And go and check out What If Naruto Went Dark and What If Naruto Was Madara Grandson. I did those two yesterday, guys. Go and destroy your light goal so you can get the other part. Once as their light goal has been destroyed, I'll be posting the next part immediately. So go and check them out. And yeah, without further ado, let's get straight in this episode. Start the intro. So last time we left off, the finals of the preliminary happened and Naruto told his sensei to go and train Karu because she was going to face off against Gaara, and Naruto know Gaara is a savage killer, so she need to get stronger to face off against him. Naruto went to a bathhouse where he meet up with Jiraiya and he wanted a key to unlock the full power of the tail beast. But after playing a prank on Jiraiya end up escaping, and now Kurama is cursing at Naruto to go and find Jiraiya before it took him another 5 years to see him again. As Kurama is talking to Naruto, the both of them are cursing. And another thing, Kurama said, you better not attack him again this time or I swear I will rip through the seal and devour your soul. Consequences be damned. Can you shut up? I found him, said Naruto. How the hell did you find him so fast? Said Kurama. Did you really just ask me that? Naruto replied. Oh, I was so mad I forgot that we can sense him. Dumbass, said Naruto. At least I do not fail basic maths. Shut up, Naruto said, as he was embarrassed that he couldn't figure out the basic maths in the first part of the Chunin exam. Naruto had trapped Jiraiya near one of the training grounds. Jiraiya was sitting by a fire, cooking up some fish he had caught near the stream. Jiraiya saw Naruto coming towards him, and he told Naruto to have a seat, and he offered Naruto one of the fishes, and Naruto quickly accepted. No kid, Jiraiya said, I should be furious about the prank that you just pulled on me, but it reminds me so much of your mother. Wait, my mom was a prankster too? Naruto asked. Yes, her favorite prank was to use the transformation jutsu to turn into an attractive man and walk around to expose the unfaithful women in couples. What the hell? That's like my prank, except I turn into the sexy jutsu, the female form, said Naruto. Yeah, I heard of that. The third Hokage told me that you pulled the sexy jutsu on him, and you also did it to stun the Uchiha boy. Yeah, Naruto said with a smile on his face. I even made him girlfriend cursed at him. That pink hair girl is really crazy. Jerry had a creepy smile on his face. Would you be willing to show me this amazing jutsu in exchange for the key? Jiraiya asked. Deal, Naruto quickly said. Okay, you ask for it, Naruto said as he performed the sexy jutsu and turned into a very attractive girl and blew kisses towards Jiraiya. Jiraiya stared for a few seconds until blood started to pour out of his nose. Naruto then revert back to his normal form. Okay, Jiraiya said, let's do this. as he take out a scroll out of his pouch and put it in front of Naruto and told Naruto to sign the toad contract. Wait, what are you talking about? Why cannot we unlock the seal first? You remember what I told you a long time ago, said Jiraiya, as Naruto had a small flashback of when he met Jiraiya some years ago, and Jiraiya told him that one day he will make him sign a toad contract. Back to the present, and because Jiraiya wants to make sure that he is ready before bestowing such a power on him. And when you master the summoning jutsu of your father, secret jutsu, I will give you the key, not before. Fine, it will be a piece of cake to master the summoning jutsu. I bet my dad, flying thunder god, won't be that hard to master either. Won't. Don't get ahead of yourself, kid. I cannot teach you a technique I don't know. Then, what secret technique of my dad do you plan to teach me? I thought his only secret technique was the flying thunder god. There was one other technique your dad invented. It is called the Rasengan. There are only two people in the world that know this technique right now. It's myself and your father, last living student. Follow me and I'll show you. Jiraiya brought Naruto to a huge tree in the middle of the forest. He held out his hand and a blue ball started to form in his palm. This is the Rasengan, your father's secret jutsu. I told you that he created. So, what made this Rasengan so special? Instead of answering Naruto's question, Jiraiya slammed the Rasengan into the tree as his hand break through the other part, destroying the middle section of the tree. Whoa, you got to teach me how to do that, said Naruto. First thing first, sign the toad contract. Once you master that, then we move on to the Rasengan. Okay, Naruto said, this summoning jutsu is going to be easy. 1 week later, as Naruto stood there, this summoning jutsu is bullshit. How many times do I have to tell you? You have to learn to control the amount of chakra you use for this jutsu. You don't want to summon a messenger when you're trying to summon a warrior, do you? Said Jiraiya. I get it already. I just suck at chakra control. Well, you better hurry up and learn. It's already been a week. The opponents you are going to go up against are no joke. You may need the assistance of a toad to defeat them. An orange-skinned toad jumped between the two. Hey Jiraiya, lay off the kid, why don't you? He is trying his hardest. This is a Jonin level technique, so you cannot expect a Genin level to master it in a week, the small toad said, trying to calm down the situation. I appreciate your concern, Yamakashi, but his father already had this jutsu mastered within 3 days, and I taught him when he was younger than Naruto. Well, maybe you should just go find another prodigy like him to go train then. Naruto stormed off as he said that, leaving the toad and Jiraiya by themselves. You've really done it now, Jiraiya, as a small toad hopped off to catch up with Naruto, leaving Jiraiya by himself. That boy is so much like his parents, said Jiraiya. I've got an idea how to motivate him. Skipping to Naruto, he was walking down the alley in the village. Stupid old man and his stupid jutsu. Naruto kept mumbling to himself until the toad jumped on his head, surprising him. Yo, Naruto, don't let the old man get you down. You're doing great considering how hard this jutsu is. I know, but it's not enough. At this rate, I won't have the jutsu mastered at the end of the month. As Naruto was passing by a fence, he heard a voice. So Hinata, how has your training been going? Naruto quickly hopped on the fence to look over as he saw Hinata talking with Sakura. Both of their backs were turned to him and they were both walking away. It's been hard, but I think I'm making some progress, Hinata said. Man, I'm so jealous of you, said Sakura. You get to compete in the finals. Yeah, but I'm a little nervous. That sand girl seemed really strong. She knocked out Choji in one shot. You're strong too, Hinata. You beat Tenten, and she had all those weapons. Oh, she's been helping me train along with Neji. She's actually a nice girl. We started to become friends. You should invite her to our next girls' day, said Sakura. The more the merrier. The two girls disappeared from Naruto's sight as they were too far. Hey Naruto, who are those two girls? The toad asked. You look like you knew them. They took the Chunin exam too. The pink one failed, but the cute one is still in it. Oh, so you like that girl, eh? I really want to impress her. That's why I am trying to master the jutsu the old man is teaching me. What the hell are you doing here then? Get back there and show the old bastard that you can do it, said the toad. I will, said Naruto, a confident voice, as he started to run pretty fast as the toad grabbed onto his hair so he wouldn't fall off. Hinata is doing her best to train for the exam, Naruto thought as he was running. So, I will do my best too. When Naruto got back to the training ground, he saw Jiraiya sitting on a rock with two folders in his hands. He motioned for Naruto to come over and sit next to him, which was what Naruto did. People love to assume things, Jiraiya said. They hear about the fourth Hokage and his great accomplishments and assume that he was some great prodigy. They couldn't be farther from the truth. Jiraiya handed one of the folders to Naruto. Naruto looked inside and discovered his father's school records. Look at the grades for the first year in the academy. Naruto did as Jiraiya instructed. Chakra control, D. Taijutsu, D. Ninjutsu, D. Genjutsu, F. Weapon, D. My father's grades are really bad, said Naruto. Your father wasn't a prodigy at the first. Now check the rest of the grades. Naruto did as he was instructed, only to become surprised. This cannot be right. His first year school was so bad. But the second year, he had an A rank in every single category. Except for ninjutsu, he had an S rank in that. Your father's second year at the academy was the year your mother moved to the village. That amazing turnaround in your father's grades was because of her. What do you mean, Naruto asked. I remember the first day your father told me about when he met your mother. About how she loudly said that she would be the first female Hokage. And when the other students made fun of her red hair, she picked them up and tossed them through the window. He said he fell in love with her at first sight. At first, he started to study and tried to impress her. After they officially became a couple a few months later, she came to his house and they will study together. He handed Naruto another folder. This one is my school records. Naruto opened it up and his jaw almost dropped to the floor. You had an F in every single category, old man. I was the biggest loser of them all. I only went to the academy every other day. I spend most of my time playing hooky. It's a miracle I made Genin at all. Jiraiya then looked up. Don't ever think that just because you aren't a prodigy, you cannot become a great ninja. Naruto felt the fire in his stomach ignite and he jumped up ready to go. Let's go. I will master that stupid summoning technique right now. Naruto and Jiraiya spend the whole night training. Now, 2 weeks has passed since they began training. Naruto finally mastered the summoning technique, and it was finally time for him to learn the Rasengan. It was the dawn of a new day, and Naruto was headed out into the forest training ground to meet Jiraiya. On his way there, he noticed a rock in his way, a square-shaped rock with two big eye holes in it. It was obviously Konohamaru. Naruto didn't have time for this, so he quickly jumped over the rock and created a shadow clone so Konohamaru wouldn't see him. Then, the real Naruto headed off to the training ground and leave the shadow clone behind. The shadow clone picked up a rock and revealing Konohamaru and his three friends squished in a small position. Konohamaru jumped up and launched at the fake Naruto, trying to punch him, and he was successful, but only for Naruto to puff. In a puff of smoke, Konohamaru had a sad look on his face, knowing that Naruto just tricked him. At the training ground, "Where is that old pervert?" Naruto said, as he looked around to find Jiraiya. He then went over to Jiraiya's tent and spotted a note and read it himself. "Gone to buy the supplies to teach you the technique. I'll be back by noon. I left you a scroll with wind techniques. Go have a look. It's in the tent by my bag." Naruto opened the tent, went inside, and found the scrolls and see that they were basic wind chakra technique. As Naruto was reading about the wind style techniques, it got him thinking. He already knew some basic wind style jutsus and he could use them effectively in combat. He then decided to try something with his shadow clones. He left the tent and summoned a shadow clone and instructed it to throw a kunai to a nearby tree. The clone threw it and it was effectively bedded in the tree, but it didn't went that far. Naruto instructed the clone to do it again. The clone then fling another kunai, but this time Naruto used wind style from his mouth. The wind pressure of his attack with the kunai fly right through the tree and embedded itself in a rock, breaking the tree midsection. Whoa! Naruto and his clone jumped back, surprised at their own power. "Impressive," a voice said behind Naruto. Naruto turned around to see who was behind him. It was an elderly man, covered in lots of bandages. He looked like an old shinobi. His arm was in a sling, most likely injured in a mission. "Who are you?" Naruto asked. "My name is of no importance. I was out for a casual stroll and just happened to see you practicing your wind style technique. You don't see a lot of wind style users anymore. It is a rare thing. I happen to know a few wind style jutsu myself. Let me give you an example." The old man pulled out a kunai and formed a chakra blade from it. He swung it and sent a blade straight towards a tree, cutting it in half. Holy crap, Naruto couldn't believe his eyes. This old man was powerful. "In my prime, I was considered one of the greatest wind style shinobi in the world," the old man casually remarked. "Sir, would you please teach me that technique? I got the chunin exam coming up in a few weeks. I would love nothing more than to pass on my teachings to the next generation. But I'm sorry to say, I cannot teach a boy from another village." "Oh, I understand," Naruto said with a look of sadness on his face. "Perhaps if you were to come to me wearing a leaf headband, I would change my mind." "Think about it, child. I could make you one of the greats." As the old man began to walk away, "Naruto, this guy isn't what he seems. Check his chakra," said the Nine Tail. Naruto did as what he was instructed, and he was speechless at what he felt. What the hell is this guy? He has a dozen different chakra signatures. It's like he's a bunch of different people rolled into one. During the last war, all villagers were experimenting with gene splicing. I think that guy is one of them. "What is gene splicing?" Naruto asks. "Giving the natural abilities of one being to another being. Say, for example, there was a shinobi with a bloodline that gave him immunity to all poison. With gene splicing, you can take that ability and give it to another person." "That sounds a lot like what Orochimaru tried to do to me." "That's because was exactly what he tried to do to you. It was made illegal after the Third War because how dangerous it was. Very few people can survive the process. No kidding, Naruto said. He may be an old cripple, but that guy is a lot stronger than he lets on. So strong, I almost missed the genjutsu he tried on you. Wait, what? Why the hell wasn't that the first thing you told me? I would have told him to get out of here. That was exactly why I didn't tell you. I wanted to see what he wanted. He is obviously trying to convince you to stay in this village. The genjutsu he attempted was a subtle persuasion jutsu. You would have been put it in his hands and not even realized it. Huh, Naruto said. He has to do a lot more than that if he want me to leave my friends and my families. Speaking of family, here Jiraiya come. We are finally about to learn the Rasengan. Jiraiya showed up with 3 bags full of different kind of balls. I can see that you are enjoying that wind scroll I left you. Now, let's get to the real fun stuff. He tossed a water ball, Loon, towards Naruto who caught it. There are 3 steps to master the Rasengan. First step, rotation. But guys, I'm gonna end this episode right here. If you want to see next part of this, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on the bell notification as they posted. Yeah, guys, get this one to 300 likes, and you'll be getting next part as soon as possible. But for now, guys, I'm out. Peace.